This is Stan Fischler, and this is the Power Play Break, the place to talk about pucks.
Hey everybody, it's Chris Riley here for the Power Play Break again. We come to the boards tonight in Seaside Heights, New Jersey. We're here with Steven Gianta of the New Jersey Devils. Steven, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
Let's go back now. This show is more about you and not so much, you know, professional hockey. Talk about your beginnings in Rochester, New York with your brother Brian and how you guys really got into the game of ice hockey and started playing.
Oh, I'm the baby of three kids, so I was dragged to the rink, you know, almost every day. So naturally, my parents put me on the ice when I was real young, and it started from there.
You know, Brian stood out right away, probably. Did you look up to him coming up? I mean, he was a few years older than you. I mean, was he kind of your influence growing up?
He definitely was. You know, obviously I took a very similar path, you know, going to BC and obviously signing with New Jersey. But, you know, anytime you see a smaller guy have success, you know, you're naturally going to look up to him. And he just happened to be my brother. And I was able to kind of learn from him as he went through it and kind of use those experiences for myself.
Talk about now, you're playing for the Rochester Junior Americans, and the National Development Team for USA Hockey comes along and selects you. Were you nervous, excited, saying, oh, okay, I'm taking a big next leap, or?
I was definitely nervous. You know, it's a big unknown. You know, I was playing for a junior team in Rochester and living at home, it's, you know, you're comfortable with that. You know, you're at your own high school that you know all your friends, and when you get taken out of that comfort zone, it's definitely a change. And going to Ann Arbor, I was lucky enough that my mom moved there with me, so I didn't have to live with a family. So it was nice having that almost at home comfort feeling of having your mom there with you. But it's definitely, I definitely had the nerves of leaving home.
Talk about the leap. You know, a lot of guys talk about on the show here, they've talked about the leap they've made. How much of it was a leap to get to that development program? Because that is the elite 20, 25 guys at your age level at that time at USA Hockey. I mean, there's no slouches. The fourth line is as good as the first line.
Yeah, it's definitely a huge leap because, you know, you take that and you go into international play. And, you know, I remember one of my first international tournaments, I played against Kovalchuk. And I was nowhere near the level that he is, and I'm still not, and that, you know, he's an elite player. But it just kind of shows you what you deal with on a game-to-game basis, and it's pretty cool.
Talk about you're playing at that level, and yeah. Colleges are coming along. Your brother's now at BC. Did he say, hey, you know, Jerry York here wants you at BC, or was it they knew about you, or were you kind of think, maybe I want to take my own path, or did you want to follow in Brian's footsteps?
I wanted to take my own path. Obviously, you also look up to your brother, so you want to take that path as well. And I explored different options when that process came along, and it naturally came down to BC and Miami of Ohio, and it was a very, very tough decision. But never pressured by my parents. Brian had a great experience when I went on my visit to BC, and that's ultimately what made the decision.
Now talk about, you come out of the U.S. development program, and now you're gonna go play college hockey. Years ago, most kids, when they were 18, went to play in college. You had that 2 years of seasoning, as they're calling it now, to come in. Was it a big adjustment? Because now you're in high school, now you're in a development program, you come up to the college ranks, now you got the work is different, there's more expectations on you, all those different things. I mean, a lot of young men don't know really what it takes when you get there. It's a very frightening experience.
It is, and you don't realize what it takes until you get there. And you know, like you said, I came out of high school, I was 18, going to, you know, college, and now I'm really on my own. There's no parents, there's nothing. You're on your own, you're figuring out, you know, life as it goes. And it's a pretty cool thing to experience.
Now you go to the Heights, and for those of you out there, the Heights is Boston College up in Chestnut Hill. Talk about, you step out there, and you know, now you're playing with guys a little bit older, a little bit stronger, a little bit faster. What expectations did Jerry York have on you? Or did your brother say, hey, this is what Coach York expects of you when you come here to BC?
No, you know, Brian is just kind of, you know, he gave me advice, but it was always, you know, learn on my own. And he, you know, he told me it was a good choice of going to BC because Coach York not only is a good coach, but he's one of the nicest men you'll ever meet. And you know, he teaches you about life and you know, he has his plan for you, and it you know, his expectations are to come in, play a role, and learn about life essentially, and have some fun playing hockey while you do it. This is Steven Gianta, the New Jersey Devils. You're watching the Power Play Break, the place to talk about pucks.